Rhythm is the primary guide for attention in music. Tempo and groove are easy to encode, and so that is often the first element of music to engage us. As you have learned, the predictability of a steady pulse frees up our attention to guide it to the melody or the lyrics, helping us to memorize music. The more constant the rhythm, the quicker and easier it is for the nervous system to lock onto it. Predictability gives a powerful assist to memory formation. If you can remember the rhythm, you have a clue as to the phrase length or the point at which the lyrics are most likely to rhyme. Rhythm perception comes from accenting the duration or the intensity of tones. Accents are attentional markers that help us automatically keep track of musical organization. Accents are what separate entrainment, which is easy, from rhythm perception, which is harder. Entrainment involves keeping time with a metronome, like a car's turn signal. It doesn't require complex computations. Rhythm perception involves extracting a pulse from musical beats or tones, finding a groove, and then moving in sync with it. Now here I'm going to be referring to a record, and by that I mean a recording, regardless of whether it's on vinyl, CD, cassette, or digital streaming platform. An accent is anything that is attention-getting, like a change in loudness, or duration, or pitch. For example, let's imagine a simple kick-snare-kick-snare pattern in a 4-4 time signature at 105 beats per minute. The record maker can choose to accent the kick on beats 1 and 3, or accent the snare on the 2 and 4. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, versus 1, 2, 3, 4. Or they can choose to vary the duration, for example, long, short, long, short, versus short, long, short, long. Some music, like techno or electronic dance music, will choose to not accent the beats at all so that your attention is drawn to the rhythm as a whole and not the sections of the piece. Western tonal music has reached every corner of the globe, for better and for worse. Most people on Earth have had some passive exposure to modern popular music. Passive exposure teaches our brains how music typically goes. The first step in understanding basic pop music is awareness of its metrical structure. It's easier to detect changes in metrically regular patterns like 3-4, 4-4, or 6-8 time than in a complex metrical time signature like 7-4, which is one reason why popular music relies on common time. From birth, the auditory system begins organizing sounds into familiar and not so familiar categories. This is most obvious for speech, but it happens for music too. Infants rapidly learn from statistical regularities what to expect of musical rhythms in their culture. Youngsters learn. 1. Important musical events tend to happen on the important beats. This is shown in a range of musical styles. 2. Musical events occurring on metrically strong beats are more easily recognized, and they're less likely to be confused with events that occur in weaker metrical locations. Turns out that performers make fewer mistakes on the metrically important notes. And 3, just as pitch perception depends on the tonal context, beat perception depends on the metrical context. Whether a snare hit feels strong or weak, short or long, depends on the beats that came before it. Composers, arrangers, and record makers have an instinct for knowing how to focus listeners' attention on where they want it to go. For example, to help us notice a particularly poignant lyric, a producer may have a new instrument enter at that point or have an instrument drop out there. The beginning notes of the chorus are often subtly louder than other parts. An unexpected pitch or a chord change resets our expectations, wakes up our internal clock, and refocuses our attention on the song. Anticipating when the next beat will arrive and correctly timing our movements to it contribute to our enjoyment of music. In the next video, we will look at how this works for tonality, the distinction between consonance and dissonance.